start by telling us just a little bit about your character for young fans who might not be so familiar with Shakespeare?
I play Benedick in Much Ado About Nothing by William Shakespeare. He's a proud and feisty kind of chap who starts the story mocking love and marriage, and of course falls in love himself and becomes something of a buffoon until finally coming through and making sense of it all. And I would call this the first romantic comedy. This set the mold for hundreds of years to follow. So it's a great honor to take on this role and this play.
Of course, I mean, you're working again with Joss. What makes him a genius, and what makes you keep coming back to working with him?
Joss is extraordinary and unique. To work with Joss and Amy is, for me, is the Holy Trinity, really, as far as work. I adore the three of us working together, rehearsing together, filming together. Of course, I adore them off screen as much as on. So this was a work of love for me.
Working under considerable time pressure in quite intimate surroundings, can you talk a little bit about the production process?
Well, frightening, really. 12 days. It's unheard of. You'd be hard pressed to come up with an hour of telly in 12 days. So when Joss said we're shooting it, the whole thing in 12 days, I thought he was insane. But before I had time to think about that, I said yes, and there wasn't time to even worry about it. We made decisions quickly and moved on with it. He had a strong vision, a strong interpretation. He and I saw it very much in the same way. It was a great deal of fun, funded with more love than money.
We've seen countless adaptations of Shakespeare, but what do you think sets this one in particular apart?
I think this has found a very comfortable place between modern and contemporary, but still respecting the playwright. I think it's hip and sexy, but not full of itself. It's very easy and approachable. I think people will be pleasantly surprised with the interpretation, and if they love Shakespeare, then they'll be glad to add this one to the repertoire. And if they've never seen Shakespeare, which I know is probably rare in this country, but they will find this very understandable and enjoyable.
What else are you working on at the moment? Where are we going to see you next after this?
I did a sort of genre web series called H+ that did very well on the internet. Brian Singer and Warner Online put it together, and it was something we were all very proud of. We're working on season 2 of that now, and otherwise this is it. I'm promoting this movie, and we'll see what comes up next.
Have you got a message to
Joss and Amy call again?
I guess, have you got a message to particularly young fans, I guess, watching this, why they should go and give Shakespeare a chance?
Well, who hasn't sat in a classroom and fallen asleep over the thick tome of the collected plays of William Shakespeare? But I think this one will keep you awake. And even more so, I think you will be happily surprised with this version.
Obviously, it's a comedy, but did you have any particularly amusing experiences on set? I guess especially given the extraordinary time pressure you were under to get things done.
Well, we were having a great deal of fun making it, and there were certainly surprises along the way, but I think the fun that we were having making it is very much captured on film. So when you see it, you'll see all of the enjoyment we were having in the process of doing it, and with very little expectation or pressure. I mean, it was, in a sense, this was a glorified home movie at Joss's house.
What's Joss's house actually like? Are there lots of toys and fun things lying around to play with when you're not filming?
Yeah, it's all there. You can see it. I mean, we may have added a few for one or two scenes, but yeah, that's it. There's actually more that didn't make it on film that could have, but just didn't work into the story. But yeah, thanks for donating your house, Joss. We've tried to come up with something approachable and easy and hip. I think this is a cool, sexy version. I think young and old will enjoy this. Look, if you don't know Shakespeare or care for Shakespeare, which may not be the case in this country, but if you don't, I think you'll find this understandable and enjoyable. And if you consider yourself an expert, I think you'll see something fresh that you haven't seen before here.